Hello. I'd like to share with you another one of our blogs from the book Touch of Peace. This is called Seeing Kanchenjunga, and it's number 65. And this blog was inspired by an experience that we had when we were visiting India. This time, it was a few years ago with Swami Kriyananda. And we were up in Darjeeling, which is in where the tea comes from, beautiful tea plantations. And it's has wonderful views. It's in northern India, wonderful views of the Himalayas. And we had a nice few days there just meditating, and Swami always enjoyed strolling around and going to tea shops. But wherever we went, people would say to us, "Have you seen Kanchenjunga? Have you seen Kanchenjunga?" Well, I was so new to India at this point, I didn't even know what Kanchenjunga was. But I didn't think I'd seen it. But it seemed to be something very important to people. And then one day we hired a car that was very early, a guide car. We had to leave before the light even came up, about 4 o'clock in the morning. And they were going to drive us to a point with a wonderful view of the Himalayas called Tiger Hill. And we got there and it was quite foggy. We couldn't see anything. And they said, "We can't guarantee that you'll see the Kanchenjunga." By this time, I realized it was a mountain, the name of a mountain. But then the fog cleared, and there was Kanchenjunga. It was beautiful. It was so magnificent. And the dawn light was just coming through on the snow, and it had that beautiful glow to it. And it felt like a divine being. It felt like a darshan, that the mountain was revealing its spiritual power to us. And we were there for a while, and then we drove back to Darjeeling. And Swami didn't go with us on that little jog, and we told him what had happened. But from that time on, everywhere I looked, I saw Kanchenjunga, because Darjeeling is built almost on the slopes of it. And if you look directly up, there's Kanchenjunga. And I realized, now that I knew what I was looking for, I could see it. And this has so many spiritual implications in our own life. If we don't know what we're looking for, we go around in a fog. What am I supposed to do to make me happy? What's worth living for? What goal shall I set? But if we know what we're looking for, if we really introspect and say, "What do I want to accomplish in my life? What goals do I want? What do I want to find within myself? What state of consciousness?" I had a very dear person in my life, in fact, my mother, who was a very wise, loving woman. And toward the end of her life, she said to me, "I always thought when I would get older, I would get wise, but it just didn't happen." But of course, she was wise in her own way. But I thought, if she had known how to seek truth in the way Master has given up these teachings, she would have found what she was looking for. So to see Kanchenjunga, to see joy, to see peace in your life, through the fog of everything that happens, we have to know what we're looking for. And the more clearly you hold it in your mind, the more you will see it everywhere, through past all the fogs and distractions. So I invite you, as I have tried to do with my life, try to find what's important, focus on it, and do everything you can to find it. God bless you.